In the last video, we'd got to the point where we had secured our controller using the authorize attribute, and we had got to the position where a user could register and then log in, and when they logged in, they'd be returned one of these JWTs, JSON web token, that they could then use to actually access the website. But we hadn't actually done that last bit of it. So let's pick up from there. So you will need to look at the previous video, I think, if you haven't seen it so far. This is really intended to follow on. But just to show you very quickly, so we had our book review controller where we had that authorize attribute. That means we're not allowed in there until we log in, and we've got to do a bit more work to make that work properly. And then also our authentication controller where we had the register and the login. But of course, that's not authorized because you need general members of the public to be able to do that. And so if we run that up, then we had our book reviews controller, but if I try to access that, I'm not allowed to. Rather strangely, we get a 404. We should really be getting a 401 there, but we'll fix that in the rest of this video. But I also had the register. I've already registered, so let's just log in. So if I log in, you may recall that I logged in with a username of Jasper/Kent, and my password was the very insecure PA$W0RD. And if I execute that, then what we get back is this response where we've got the JWT token. That's the real thing we need. And then just for information, we're also telling you when this expires so you know when you need to renew it or anything like that. So now let's get that working so we can actually go back in with that token and get access to the code. And so what we're going to do is we're going to go to the program and do some more configuration during the whole startup process. And so what we need to do is, firstly, we need to configure the authentication. So down the bottom here, it doesn't really matter where, as long as before that builder.build, we're going to say builder.services.addAuthentication. And then in the options, we're going to set up a number of things, all of which are basically going to use this JWT authentication. So we're going to say options.default authentication scheme, and that's going to be JWT bearer defaults. Get hold of that. And that comes from a different package, so we'll just install that automatically. And then that's going to simply be .authentication scheme. And then we're going to have two others, very similar. So we're going to have the default challenge scheme, and we're going to have simply the default scheme. Easy enough to set all of those three to being the JWT. That's telling the system that we're using JSON web tokens. As I said in the previous video, there's lots of other ways you can do authentication, but that's the one we've got here. And then what we're going to do is configure that specifically. So we're going to say add JWT bearer, and again have a set of options on there. And in this lot, I'm going to firstly say options.save token equals true. That simply means that once the token's been sent in, it's going to store it in memory, so it'll be accessible from elsewhere in the application after the basic validation's been done. And then I'm going to say options.token validation parameters equals new token validation parameters. Get rid of that long namespace there. And then what I'm going to pass in there, we're going to have the valid issuer, and I'm going to take that from the config file. So remember, in our config file, we had used, when we were creating the token, we had the valid audience, the valid issuer, and the secret. So we're going to make use of those now when we are verifying that the token is correct. So we're going to say valid issuer, and then builder.configuration, and then JWT:\valid issuer. And then I'll repeat that for the audience. So that's going to be valid audience. And then I need to set up the secret. So that's going to be a thing called issuer signing key. But let's just make this a little bit different. Let's up here, I'm going to say var secret equals. And so here we'll just say builder.configuration and then JWT:\secret. Remember, there's risk that could be null. So we're also going to throw the exception there. So in fact, we can just take that off the authentication controller, because remember here, we're doing the same sort of thing. So we'll just put that on the end there. And then in here, we're going to, on that issuing key, we're going to say equals, and then we've got this new symmetric security key. And again, same sort of thing as we had before. So encoding, get hold of the namespace, and then UTF-8, and then get bytes from that secret. And then the last thing we need to do, having configured the authentication, we need to use it. And so down the bottom here, we put it just before the use authorization. So when we're doing the configuration up here before the builder.build, the order doesn't matter too much, but here it is important. And if you get those the wrong way around, you'll get some very strange behavior. Authentication comes first. Remember, authentication, as we said in the last video, is the user demonstrating they are who they say they are. Authorization is then us deciding what this particular user is allowed to do. So if we now run that up, we're now in a situation where if we send that JWT back with our request to get the book reviews, then we will be allowed access. But the problem is, we haven't at the moment got a means to provide that token in Swagger when we're sending the data over. So you can see we're still getting the 401. That's sorted now. That was a 404 before, but now it's the correct 401 for we're not allowed access. But how do we send that token back? Well, we'll see how we can do that in Swagger in a moment, but let's first use Postman. So if I just bring up Postman. So this is a standard tool that lots of people use for accessing web services and testing web services. And what we can do there is if we go back to Swagger and actually just steal the URL that we had for getting hold of those book reviews and pop it in here on a get request, send that, as you'd expect, we get back that 401 unauthorized. But what we have to do is pass the JWT as an item in the header. So if we go to headers here, and I'm going to add an authorization header. And then what I need to do is back on the Swagger, let's log in so we can get hold of our JWT. I could have logged in Postman, but I just find it a bit easier to use Swagger. So if we do that, and then that gives us our JWT. So we'll copy that. And then back in Postman, we'll type bearer space and then the token that we have there. So that's the bearer token that we've got. And so if we now send that, then you can see we're getting the information coming back. So that token that we passed in was being examined by the code that we put in here, checked, decrypted to check that nothing had been tampered with. And then we can see that it allows us in, even though we had that authorize on the controller. So that's basically what we've got to do. But I personally prefer to use Swagger rather than Postman. And so let's add that last feature in there. So let's go back here. And now let's configure Swagger to make use of this. So if we go up here, here is our add Swagger gen. We've seen in previous videos lots of ways that you can configure Swagger. So we could combine that configuration with what I'm going to do here. But what I'm going to do is make it so we can enter that in Swagger. And so what we need is to put in some options here. So let's say options, gives, and then we'll put those in there. And we're going to say options.add security definition. And we're going to call this bearer. Call it what you like, really, but that will match up with what we're talking about. And then we say new open API security scheme. Again, let's use the using for that one. And then that, again, we can provide some parameters. So we're going to say where it's going to go. So in equals parameter location.header. So it's going to be a header. Description, so this is purely what is going to be displayed to the user when they're using Swagger. So we'll say, please enter bearer and then the JWT. So that's what we put in just a moment ago when we saw it in Postman. Again, that word bearer on the front is vitally important. Then we're going to give it a name. Again, call it what you like, but we're calling it authorization just for display, really. And then finally, we give it a type. And that one is security scheme type API key. So that's set up a definition. We then need to make use of that definition. So we now say var scheme equals new open API security scheme once again. But in this case, the only way we configure this one is to reference the one that we've just put in. So here we're just going to say reference equals new OpenAPI reference. And then what we're typing is this other scheme. So we say type equals reference type and then security scheme. And then this is where the name comes in. So we say ID equals bearer. We're using the word bearer a lot, but that bearer there corresponds with that bearer up there. And then there's one last thing I've got to do. Having put those together, we've now got to actually register them. So the last thing I'm going to do here is say options.add security requirement. And then we say new open API security requirement. And that one is a dictionary for which we're going to have a key of scheme that we've just created on the line above, and then a value of just an empty list of strings. So we can say array.empty string in there. So that just hooks all of that up. Again, lots of variations we can have on this, but now when we run this up, you can see that it's added at the top of the page this authorize button. And when I click that, you can see it's got the information like the please enter bearer JWT, and it allows us to put a value in there. So let's log in again. I could have used the existing one, but I don't remember where I put it. So let's just re-log in to get a new JWT. So Jasper space Kent, password, execute that, copy that token, and then go into the authorize. And again, just like we had in the Postman, we've got to put in the word bearer, then paste in the token, authorize that. And all that's done so far is that means that the Swagger page is now remembering that token and will send it off in the header every time we do a request, just like we had sending it from Postman. So now, finally, if we go down to the book reviews and click try it out and execute, this time we're getting the data coming back because it's passed in that header and we can then make use of it. And so if we scroll up there, you can see there we can see the authorization header that it's sending off with all of that. So that's that stage complete. So as well as what we did in the first video, which was getting the server to issue the JWT, we've now got the ability to then send the JWT back as part of the authorization header and therefore get access to any restricted area of the web service. Plus we've added the ability to Swagger to make that relatively easy for us to do that. One other thing we need to do, which you may have seen there, is we also need to log out. So if we just scroll up to the authorize button and click on that, you can see it's just got that log out. And if I click that, all it does is basically forgets about that JWT. So now if I do that, it's simply not going to send it. And so if I try and execute again, we get the 401. So logging out doesn't involve sending any message to the server saying we're logging out. It simply means we forget the token and stop sending it. What we next need to do is actually start writing some genuine clients rather than just Swagger, which is purely a development tool. And so with those, we can start looking at this as a real application. And I'm going to do that in a couple of ways. The first way I'm going to do it is with an Angular front end. And then in later videos, we'll look at some other front ends. So hope that was helpful. If you enjoyed it, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.